Lately, I've been looking into wheel dynamics. Now, wheel dynamics, you say, they just roll, right? It doesn't get much simpler than that. But, for example, if you put some weight on it, it gets squished. You get rolling resistance and varying radius. This video is not about that, however, but a less often discussed tire phenomenon, elastic wheel slip. For this one, you don't even need to have a compressed tire. You just apply torque and roll at the same time. As the torque twists the tire, the patch in front of the contact point is compressed and the patch behind it is stretched. Of course, this animation is super exaggerated, wheels don't get this warped, except maybe for drag racing. Let's look at one of these splines between the wheel hub and the surface. They visualize the distortion of the rubber material. Now, near the contact point it has the most deflection, and around the opposite side it has the least deflection. Let phi be the angle of the spline on the wheel hub, and let gamma be the angle of the spline on the surface. In a load-free condition, phi will equal gamma. When torque is applied, depending on which part of the wheel you're looking at, the difference will change. You can see on the graph that the difference is not evenly distributed. The contact point is at 0 degrees. To visualize better, I'm adding the extensions of these functions as you make complete rounds around the wheel. As I said earlier, the wheel is not compressed, the outside shape is a circle. So locally, the wheel's movement can be written in equation form that the forward displacement ds is equal to the small change in angle d gamma times the radius. Due to the twisting effect of the torque, the corresponding part of the wheel hub will travel a different amount. If you need to express the correlation with the hub rotation, you can divide and multiply by d phi. Now this d gamma d phi term is the derivative of the function that connects the two angles. Back to our graph, here's the contact point and the local slopes around it. The slope before is shallower and the one after is steeper, meaning the patch in front of the contact is shorter and the patch behind the contact is longer. Since the rubber material is elastic, it is expected that this contraction is proportional to the applied torque. What's interesting is that the effect doesn't depend on how the whole wheel behaves, it only depends on the local deformation. Here's a comparison of what it looks like for two rolling tires, one twisted by torque and the other free rolling. And here's the same comparison with opposite torque. This is what happens when the car is braking. Well, that's all I had about wheel slip for now. Hope you found that interesting. Thanks for watching, bye!